It's CCSD Today, your insider's guide to the Charleston County School District. This week, we get an inside look at Bell Hall Elementary School in Mount Pleasant. Hear our exclusive interview with Principal Kevin Conklin. And go inside the gifted and talented program with SAIL teacher Eva Stratus. CCSD Today starts right now.
Hello everyone and welcome to CCSD Today. I'm your host, Everett German. Well, today's edition, we're over in Mount Pleasant at Bell Hall Elementary School, located right off of Long Point Road. And coming up on today's show, we'll learn about all of the great things going on right here at Bell Hall. So we're in the second grade pod right now, but we'll take a look at the entire school throughout the show. We'll take a break. More of CCSD Today when we come back.
The law firm of Young Clement Rivers has been serving the Charleston Lowcountry since 1968. All of the lawyers of Young Clement Rivers are proud to be partners with the Charleston County School District. We're convinced that the hard work of the school district employees and staff prepares our young people to face the challenges of the future. We look forward to continuing our partnership and in helping the school district to meet its standard of excellence.
And welcome back, everyone, to CCSD Today. We're on the road over at Bell Hall Elementary School, located in Mount Pleasant, right off of Long Point Road. And I'm pleased to be joined by the principal, Kevin Conklin, the leader of this school. And first of all, Kevin, thanks for joining us on the show.
Mr. German, thank you for coming.
Not a problem at all. Now, Kevin, it seemed like at one point, Bell Hall was one of the newer schools, buildings in Mount Pleasant. And now it seems like you're one of the older schools. Tell us about the history of Bell Hall.
Well, that's true. We were one of the new ones, and that would be back in 1990. So it's been quite a while. We're one of the older facilities now, but we actually have grown into our facility, and we love it. If we get an opportunity to look around as we walk about, we'll see that we've kind of made it home and made it work, and we're actually very proud of it. It's a comfy home.
Now, you talked about the layout of the school, and as we're taking a look now at just the pods, that's one thing that really kind of jumped out to me. Each grade level kind of has its own wing. Got a little camaraderie there. Everybody kind of is together.
That's true. The building is based on six pods. And as you said, it's aligned by grade level. So the students in fifth grade are all together and they can have community meetings and focus on fifth grade things or fourth grade things. And it's neat. We also have a lot of murals that have been painted. So we have themes, and those themes are usually based on the curriculum of the particular grade level. It makes it a very exciting and homey place to be walking around.
You know, when you think of a successful organization, business, you know, I don't like using the word boss, but more like leader. Boss is kind of like me and you, as opposed to leader, it's us and we. You're only as good as the people working with you. Talk about the staff here at Bell Hall Elementary.
Well, I'm very fortunate because the staff here is the reason I come every day. They are wonderful to work alongside. It is my job, as you said, to really make their job easier. And that goes along with the parents as well. We have so many people here that are working hard every day. It's my job to give them what they need. We're fortunate that our staff here is very much a veteran staff. It's a staff that has, the vast majority of us have had their own children come through this school. So there is ownership and pride that carries on. That's one of the intangibles that makes Bell Hall wonderful, I think.
Now, later on, we'll hear about the fantastic PTA that's here at Bell Hall, but your business sponsors, that's so important as well in terms of the school and funding and just having that relationship. Talk about your special business partners that you have here with Bell Hall.
That is true. We have, again, our PTA spearheads a lot of the fundraising or the business sponsor program, local businesses, and it can be instances of straight donations that it can be earmarked for our library media center, so we get an infusion of funds to bring more books and more technology right into a specific area of the school. At the same time, a business can make a donation so that a particular event just comes off. It can be supplies or you know, food or something. We are very fortunate that our community stands up all the time on behalf of our students.
Wellness is a very key component here at Bell Hall, something that you take a lot of pride in and that you really want to promote. I know you guys have a wellness program here. Share a little bit about the wellness program.
The wellness programs in the Charleston County School District are pretty established, but as you mentioned before, every program is as good as the person who's running it. And our nurse Nash, Kathy Nash, just does an incredible job spearheading it. She does everything from having health speakers come in and talk to the staff, to having social and networking mixer events for the staff, for emotional well-being. She's put together donations from the community for a staff workout room. There are after hours exercise opportunities from yoga to boot camps. She's simply amazing, and we have a lot of fun with it too. You know, we get t-shirts and we get pedometers, and she is the driving force behind our wellness program.
Every school is special. Every school is unique. What makes Bell Hall Elementary unique?
I would right off the bat say that just being so friendly and involved, and that goes with the parents and the teachers working together. It really is such an enthusiastic and positive place to be, and that is people coming up to the school and volunteering here and there, or as we've been saying, saying, I have a great idea and this is going to be an initiative that we're going to implement, and I know that the teachers have a lot on their plate, but I'm going to go above and beyond and not ask one more thing of the teacher. I'm going to help you out. A lot of times people say that they just love that little school Bell Hall. And I say, well, it's not that little of a school, but it's that intimacy that a lot of times people are misinterpreting, that it seems so intimate and small. Well, it's because people are working together and being so friendly.
Well, Kevin, I tell you what, we definitely are looking forward to learning about the school more. And after we get done with you, we're going to kind of take a tour of the school and learn about just all the great things going on here at Bell Hall. We'll talk with some teachers and I think a staff member or a member of the PTA. So we'll kind of get a really behind the scenes look at Bell Hall Elementary. And Kevin, congratulations on your success thus far. Keep up the good work. And like I said, we'll take a break. And if you don't mind, we'll go take a look at the rest of the school.
Well, I appreciate you coming. And again, being able to highlight the people of Bell Hall, because that is our strength.
All right, that's Kevin Conklin, the principal here at Bell Hall Elementary School. We'll take a break, and when we come back, we're going to sit with the librarian. Her name is Cynthia Stilo, and learn about technology and one of the cool things going on here at Bell Hall. So we'll learn about that on the other side of this break. We'll be right back. You're watching CCSD Today. We're over at Bell Hall Elementary School.
Kids learn it at their own pace, to remediate on their own, see their own results, celebrate their successes right there.
I think it's easier for me to do things like online, like it captures my attention better than like doing it in books.
It's just made it easy. It is, it, you know, it's made it easy. and the kids like it.
There are a lot of pictures. Sometimes it can be really funny, and some stories are make-believe.
I would never have believed that we would be a school that would be fully, you know, implementing technology in every classroom. So we did it, and it's due to McGraw-Hill.
Welcome back, everyone, to CCSD Today over at Bell Hall Elementary School in Mount Pleasant, right off of Long Point Road. And joining me now is the librarian, Cynthia Stilo, who enters her eighth year here at Bell Hall, librarian for 15 years. Ms. Stilo, thanks for joining us on the show.
I'm glad to be here. Thank you.
Well, we're in your home away from home, the library. And you know, as I look around, Ms. Stilo, definitely different from my days back in elementary school. A lot bigger, more technology and interactive. Just talk about how libraries have changed over time.
Well, libraries have some challenges now that they maybe didn't have years ago. We need to have our regular print collection that you're used to from the past, but we also have to have digital resources as well. So it stretches our funds to have a good collection digitally as well as print books. Students are more involved in choosing books than they maybe were in the past,
right,
because they definitely have a voice in what books we have in our library. We use standards and teacher recommendations and student recommendations to choose our books.
Now, back in the day, back in my day, Ms. Stilo, you had to, you know, check a book out, have to sign a little card. Mm-hmm. I would imagine now a little different in terms of how kids check books out even as well.
It is different now. Everything is done through an online site. We have a site called Destiny, which is our online catalog, so no more drawers to pull out and flip through. The students can access our catalog at home as well as at school, and then we check them out at our circulation desk, but we technically could check out from any computer in the school if we wanted to.
Now, you talked about technology earlier. Talk about the integration of iPads. That's one thing that's new to a lot of the schools in Charleston County School District, and I know you were actually teaching a class and using iPads and scanning QSR codes. Talk about just iPads in the elementary school.
This is a new thing to us. We started last year. We have a cart of 30 iPads that we share with everyone in the school, so it's a little bit of a challenge, but the iPads are good in giving additional resources to the students right in their hands, and we can do some pretty fancy final products too, which catches their attention. They like to make trailers and interactive posters and things like that to show what they know. And we use the iPads to integrate research. So the computer teacher, Mrs. Gibbs, and myself, and the classroom teacher all talk together and decide what standards we're trying to work on and what the children need to know. And we come up with a plan so that we can integrate technology and the curriculum standards as well. And my focus in here is teaching research skills, because that's a huge thing that classroom teachers just don't have time in their daily schedule to always get to. And it helps to have the support of the three of us working together on it.
You know, and that's interesting that you say that, because back again in the older days, librarians were just librarians. They just obviously dealt with the books that were in the library. Well, now you talk about it, you're actually teaching a class, so you're right. The collaboration of you, the computer teacher, and the teachers should make it one easy process for the kids to learn as well.
It's a great process. We started that about 8 years ago, and it continues to grow, and the children amaze us with what they're able to do as they've learned a little bit more every year. So now our first graders and second graders are doing things that maybe we originally started with fourth and fifth graders. And they just amaze us with how far they can go.
Well, I tell you, Cynthia, just you look around the library, a lot of color, a lot of energy in the place. It seems like the kids love coming to the library. It's not just checking out books and leaving, so actually learning. So congratulations, and keep up the good work to you and your staff here at Bell Hall.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. So that is Cynthia Stilo joining us here on CCSD Today, talking a little bit about technology, the library, and just how all of it kind of works hand in hand. So we thank her for joining us here on the show, and we'll take a break. More of CCSD Today over at Bell Hall Elementary School when we come back. Thank you.
Some problems are tough. Reaching your customers shouldn't be. Blue Wave and Comcast have the creative edge to make you stand out from the crowd and connect with your customers. Whether you need a commercial for television, video for your website, or a custom-made website, we are the easy solution for every advertising problem.
Kiowa Cares represents a really unique way and an organized way for folks who live here on Kiowa to connect, partner, and help those who live in our neighborhood, which includes Johns and Wabala Island.
And the idea was that many, many people who live on Kiowa very generously work as individuals in the community. But we felt as a community association, we needed to do more in a unified way to be good neighbors. And out of that came the idea of Kiowa Cares.
They brought volunteers, but most of all, they brought love. They showed love and they said, we want to be a good neighbor, and they have been a good neighbor to me and to this community.
Kiowa Cares quickly jumped on board and was really excited about the idea of supporting the local farmers and supporting the Johns Island community as well.
We're excited about the partnership, and we are in constant communication, updating them on things that that we are working on, areas where I continue to see improvement, I share with them. And so it's like we are in tune, working together, one common goal, and it's all beginning to come together.
What it means to me to be a part of Kiowa Cares is I'm able to do things I wouldn't normally have done on my own. I get the sense of community when I work with them.
We're trying to put good people in touch with organizations that could use their help.
And welcome back, everyone, to CCSD Today, still over at Bell Hall Elementary School over in Mount Pleasant. And I'm pleased to bring in Eva Stratus. She's been teaching here at Bell Hall for 26 years. And Ms. Stratus, you wear a ton of hats, whether it's the gifted and talented, SAIL, the green team, I mean, you name it, you're a part of it. And first of all, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
All right, let's start off with the gifted and talented program here at Bell Hall. Ms. Stratus, as you mentioned, you've been here for 26 years. You've seen some great kids come through this elementary school. Talk about why gifted and talented is so important at the elementary level.
Okay, I'm thinking that our program works very hard to find the potential in each child and to show them what they're capable of doing. We do a lot of authentic learning and problem solving, so they are able to see at a very young age, 8, 9, and 10, that they're able to solve problems and that they can be leaders and go on to do that as they grow up. I've seen some of my kids do great things.
And that's gotta be refreshing for you, knowing that you had a major part in not necessarily what they've become, but the fact that you kind of started off at the surface and then led them on the right path.
Yeah, I feel really proud, yes, when they come back and tell me what they're doing.
All right, now speaking of proud, the green team here, as you look around, you see a lot of recycling and green being the big initiative here. Tell us about the green team here at Bell Hall.
Okay, we have so much going on. Last year when they had a green school competition, I decided to enter it, and when I sat down to see how much we really do, it's a long, long list of 2 pages. And I thought, okay, we really are as good as I think we are. So we did enter and win. And we have a great green team in third grade that Ms. Bernard runs, and we have green leaders in every class, 2 or 3. So there's about 75 green leaders around the school. They run the whole recycling composting program in the lunchroom. They run recycling in their classrooms, and you'll see them with little buttons on today. And then we have a garden that we've just started. We have a greenhouse, and we recycle so many things. We do TerraCycling, which is juice pouches, and we're top in the nation.
Wow.
And unbelievably, we have recycled 100,000 juice pouches.
Wow, that's a lot of juice, but at least it's being recycled.
Exactly. And we recycle cereal bags and batteries. We do pop tops for the Ronald McDonald House. So what often happens, it will start a program and it doesn't go away. We just continue. So we continue to add on and do our best.
Now, it's one thing to do these types of things and recycle and so forth and so on, but it's entirely different when you're the Green School of the Year. Talk about that coming down and just how proud you were when you found out that Bell Hall was the Green School of the Year.
I was really proud, and I think it lifted up the expectations even more. We started the year, we have a committee with one teacher from every grade level, so we started out, we're the Green School of the Year, so we have to really do great. So the pressure is on us to continue.
Now, I know you guys are heavily involved in charities. You look around your room, I see you got a bunch of canned goods and so forth and so on.
Yes.
Why is charity so important and really encouraging the kids to participate?
We are so fortunate here. Bell Hall is, every child is taken care of and loved, and we need to realize that we are a small part of a bigger world, and so we try to give back to others. And so student council is the main driving behind that, and we have fundraisers once a month, and we have uniforms. So the big thing is participate, and there's a no uniform day, which is big for the kids. So right now it's canned food drive for Tri-County Family Ministries. We do every year. And we got 2,500 cans last year, so we're trying to top that. And it's Carolina versus Clemson. So that helps us to raise those cans.
That definitely adds a little more up to it when you have
exactly.
a rivalry, you know, of that nature. And you talk about giving back to the community, and I guess the thing that really stands out to me is just the ownership. You know, it's one thing for kids just to do it, but it really is teaching them, a bigger picture than just, you know, bringing in canned goods or something of that nature.
Exactly. And I want them to see they're a small part of a big world. And our motto is Bell Hall students make a difference in the world. And so each month we have a special fundraiser. We're going to do Toys for Tots this year. And Kim Oppel in the front office is one of the team managers. And so student council is going to get to go along this year and give out toys. And I think that's going to be life-changing for them.
Now, Ms. Stratus, as we mentioned earlier, you've been here for 26 years. What gives you that drive to continue teaching today's youth?
I can't seem to let it go. I love what I do, and I love to see the growth. And whenever I want to work with a special project, whether it's putting a garden together or raising food for the hungry, I will tell my students, what do you think? Do you want to help me with this? And it's this huge hurrah, you know. They're just very excited to help and give and to do any project that we come up with. And I think that's what keeps me coming and very motivated and passionate about it, teaching.
Now, you talked about the fact that, you know, having that passion, 26 years here at Bell Hall, you've
yes.
seen a lot of things, a lot of changes. I guess, what's the one thing that kind of stands out to you from maybe when you started here at Bell Hall to where you are now?
Yeah, I was thinking about that question, and when we started here, we were two schools that were overcrowded that became Bell Hall. So we were two distinct groups. Families were, you know, on one side or the other. Faculty came from those same schools. And then we quickly became the overcrowded school. We became the school with the trailers, and then when Pinckney was being built.
Right, gotcha.
So we had a lot of transition of size and different groups, but after our school split, and half went to Pinckney and half stayed, we became very united, very close-knit group, and you will hear today people saying the Bell Hall family
which is always so important. And
yes.
when you have that family feel at any school, it just seems like things just seem to go better when you have that one kind of sense of feel. So,
and I never have to worry about children not participating in something. I always have to get ready for huge participation.
Right.
We do walk to school day. We've done it for 18 years, and the whole school walks.
Wow.
And we have canned food drive, and I have to be ready for 2,000 cans. So we're always ready for everybody to participate.
Well, that is awesome, Ms. Stratus. And as you've heard, Ms. Stratus has her hand in a lot of things, whether it be gifted and talented, the charity events, the green team, and just doing a phenomenal job here at Bell Hall. And Bell Hall is very special and very lucky to have someone like this young lady to my left. So, Ms. Stratus, thank you for joining us on the show.
Thank you.
All right, that's Eva Stratus joining us here on CCSD Today. We'll take a break. More when we come back.
Some problems are tough. Reaching your customers shouldn't be. Blue Wave and Comcast have the creative edge to make you stand out from the crowd and connect with your customers. Whether you need a commercial for television, video for your website, or a custom-made website, we are the easy solution for every advertising problem.
Welcome back, everyone, to CCSD Today, still over at Bell Hall Elementary School over in Mount Pleasant, and I'm pleased to bring in Tracy Whitmore. She's in charge of the School Improvement Council as well as an active member of the PTA, and she's going to tell us about all the great projects going on here at Bell Hall. And Tracy, first of all, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right, Tracy, let's talk about SIC, which stands for School Improvement Council.
Exactly.
Give us a little more in depth about what that means here at Bell Hall.
At Bell Hall, it's a collaboration with the teachers, a couple teachers, the administration, several parents, a community member who volunteers their time to come in. We meet once a month, usually about an hour, and we just go over a variety of issues that may be presented to us or that may arise. So it could be anything from safety, which is obviously always something that we're thinking about for the kids. It could be the playground, improving our playground, nutrition, wellness, any kind of.
So basically, you're the problem solver. When something comes to you,
yes.
You're the council that tries to make it happen.
And it's an open forum, so any parent can come. They just let us know that they want to come, and they can come to the meeting and kind of present ideas or ask questions or figure out ways to get involved.
Okay, now I would imagine whether it be new playground equipment or something safety or something that the teachers would like to see, that takes money. And I know one thing that you guys do well here at Bell Hall is you have a very active PTA.
Yes.
Let's talk about, you just had your biggest fundraiser last month, that being the color run.
Tell us
how that was.
We did. We had a color run that the PTA board, who's incredible and dedicated and willing to go do anything that they need to do for the kids, they put together their own color run. Mm-hmm. And we raised $65,000 with the PTA board and an army of volunteers that put it together. And the kids loved it. They had a great time. They're in the field running and screaming and getting blasted with color and just had one of the best days of the year so far.
Something that really stood out to me in your statement right there was volunteers. Tell everybody just how important it is to have parent volunteer for PTA.
We could not. Function. The school could not function without the volunteers. I mean, like I said, it's an army. And they come in, they get up at 4 o'clock in the morning to start whatever needs to be done, and they go until late in the night to try to get things accomplished.
So that was your big fundraiser that, like I said, happened earlier or last month. Now I know coming up in the new year in 2016, you guys have a ton of things going on.
We do.
Some that are fundraisers, and also some things that are just, good for the family and the community. Tell us about some of those events that are coming up.
We have, in the spring, we start an online auction, which kicks off on March 4th. And that is, again, a collaboration with the community. We go to local businesses, most of them are pretty close to the Bell Hall School, and they donate items that families can then go online and they can try to win and bid against each other and have fun with their neighbor going back and forth. But last year we raised, I think, about $18,000.
Wow.
And again, it's families donating things, it's teachers donating things, it's local businesses donating things that we can use to raise money, and then that money will go right back to the school, and 90% of the money that we raise goes directly to the kids.
Wow. And that's obviously, when you're talking about trying to really improve a school, funds are so important, and the more funds you have, the more improvements you can do. And
exactly.
I guess it's important that it all stays right here at Bell Hall.
Exactly.
All right, now I know one other big event coming up. You got the Bell Hall Buck Bash.
The Bell Hall Buck Bash is huge. It's right at the end of the school year. The kids earn. It's one of the coolest things. We have a school-wide preventative discipline program, and so basically it's positive reinforcement. So a child comes to school and they could earn 5 Bell Hall Buck Bashes by being kind to their fellow student or by working extra hard or holding a door for someone. So it's a way to just encourage positive behavior. The kids can spend their Bell Hall Bucks at the school store, or they can save them. And they all know they can save them up for the carnival. And the end of May, we have this huge carnival. Again, there's tons of volunteers, tons of community involvement, and the kids pay for items with their Bell Hall Bucks.
Okay.
So it's just a really cool way to end the year. The kids have a ball, the families have a ball, they can all come. And the great thing is it's during the school day, so every child can attend. It's not difficult for kids to get there.
You talk about how they can use their buck dollars for the Buck Bash. But more importantly, it also can teach saving, you know, how to save, whether it be money or in this situation, your points, so that we could have it for the end of the year.
Right.
So
right,
from
exactly.
an economic standpoint,
right.
it's
There's
teaching
all kinds
life
of lessons.
Lessons. Right, mm-hmm. exactly. I know the last thing I want to ask you about was the variety show coming up in
yes.
April. Tell us about that.
April 14th, we have a variety show. And again, it's parents that volunteer to put on this variety show. The parents do not perform. But kids perform, it's third, fourth, and fifth graders, and they come in and they sing, dance, they play guitar, they do karate. I mean, it's really just different kids show their different talents and perform in front of the whole school. And it's a PTA event, and everybody gets together and kind of wraps their arms around each other, and it's just a really cool community thing to do.
Well, you know, Tracy, it sounds like a lot of great things going on at Bell Hall right now and coming up in the next year in 2016.
Absolutely.
A lot of big fun events, whether it be a fundraiser or a family event, to kind of come out and show your support. So definitely good things going on here at Bell Hall, some with the SIC, some with the fundraiser, but all in all, it's a good time to be a student and a parent of a student at Bell Hall over here in Mount Pleasant. Tracy, thanks for joining us on
Thank
the
you.
Show. All right, that's Tracy Whitmore of the School Improvement Council, as well as the PTA. That's our final segment. We'll take a break, and when we come back, we'll wrap it up here from Bell Hall. You're watching CCSD Today.
I'm Jenna Dewan Tatum.
I'm Julia Ormond.
I'm Machen Amick.
And I'm Rachel Boston.
Every 2 minutes, a woman is diagnosed with breast cancer.
Breast cancer will claim over 39,000 lives this year.
But that won't be me.
Or me.
I won't let that be me.
The end of breast cancer starts with me.
And you.
And you.
And you.
Go to MyLifetime.com to get informed and involved.
Locally sponsored by Ford. Ford is in the race for the cure.
Oh, hey, sorry, just hanging out in the media center over here at Bell Hall Elementary School. And remember, Ms. Stratus told us about the Day of Giving and the community efforts of the kids here? Well, I'm actually sitting in the chair that Bell Hall won last year. The teacher supply closet actually had a Day of Giving, and Bell Hall Elementary School raised the most money, and their reward was this nice red recliner. So I'm sitting in it, and again, just want to thank all of you for watching CCSD Today over at Bell Hall Elementary School. A special thank you to Kevin Conklin, the principal here at Bell Hall, for letting us kind of take a behind the scenes look at all the great things going on here at Bell Hall. Special thank you to all of our guests, all the teachers, staff, and more importantly, the students here at Bell Hall for welcoming CCSD Today here with open arms. So until next time, thanks for watching CCSD Today, and we'll see you next week.